Okay.
Okay, I got that one out and I pulled it up to where it's supposed to be, right up here on the top here. And now we're going to reassemble. First thing we do, pop this piece back on here. And if I was to change the O-rings, this here is one of the O-rings I'd be changing. Now we'll put our other ones over here. Now, when I'm doing my O-rings, I do need to take and put a little bit of hydraulic oil on them, or you can use the G-Man
lube.
Always. G-Man lube, PST-407.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Okay. But for the inside of the test head, this right here. Where did you go? There you are. Alright. I'm going to put these two right here. Right here. This one here. No, just, oh, there it is. Set it down right there. Okay. Now, I take, and I don't tighten them. I leave them kind of snug.
Okay, so just snug, not too tight, right?
Yep. You can see I'm able to move it a little bit. That's because I'm going to lay it on a plate and make sure it's all straight when I put it together. Now, and I've got the new seal in there.
Put your piston back in there.
Yep. Now, it takes a minute to get it in there. It's got a, you have a taper right here. Now, if you want to, you could put a little bit of G-Man lube or...
just on the taper part.
Yeah. Or some oil, like right here on this taper. And here's one of the other O-rings you'll be changing. This one here is a 2011. Goes right here for under the piston. That in here. Now, when I put it through here, what I'm looking for right here on the edge is any cuts of the O-ring, pieces of the O-ring on it.
Right.
I don't see anything. I see some of the lube and stuff I have right here that I put on it.
That way you know that the O-ring didn't get damaged.
Yeah. Now, I can take and I can put some of this, like right on here, and I can pull it back. And then push it forward, and you can see the ring where I've been wiping it.
Yeah.
The rod wiper is working, it's wiping. So, I put that on there, pull back, I see that it's wiping, and it's dry right here on my fingers. So I know the rod wipers work.
Okay. Good test to do before you put it all back together.
And you want to make sure your hands are kind of dry so you don't get the other ends.
Right.
But, because this here is the end that's going to be wiped for the but you can see that it's wiping. Yep, it's all dry. Okay, so now I got that part there. Now I'm going to put this on. Now even though it was all together once, I still like to make sure I kind of deburr it a little bit before I put it on. Wipe it down, blow it off, clean it out. And I brought a piece of plastic up so I could do this. Push this forward for a second. So I don't want to get oil all over the place, but I always lubricate the inside of the tube and I just roll the oil till I get an even coating on the inside all over it. Now and I'm watching it as it fills up in there. Got any dust or debris blown out, cleaned out, and okay. And there's the oil, and it's, I don't know if you can see it coming around right here on the end on my hand.
It's leaking out a little bit,
yeah.
Right?
And that's how I want that.
It's a little wet, huh?
All the way through. On the whole wall. And when I do that, I will put that over here. Pop that on. Right, I'm going to use that old one to keep it up there so the oil
doesn't leak out.
Yeah. For right now. There. Okay. I'm going to put that on here. Okay. So now that I got that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to get this piece here, this piece, and I'm going to connect this. Yeah. You would fall down on me.
And that just screws right on, right?
Hmm?
That just screws right on?
Yep. Got it there. I'm going to use this to hold it up. I'm going to push this through all the way to about right here.
So just leave a little bit sticking out the end.
Oh yeah, I gotta do something here real quick. Can you put that? Okay. Clean this off. Because when it was put together. There. Okay. Now it's better. All right. Right there. I'll be right back.
Okay.